Little Nature Club.
Hello, little explorers. Welcome to the Little Nature Club, where we explore, learn, and play. What shall we discover in nature today? Is it sunny, warm, and bright? Or are the rain clouds blocking the light? Maybe it's snowing, windy, or grey. Look outside and tell me.
What's the weather today? Is it sunny or snowy? What about windy or rainy? What about cloudy instead or stormy? It's windy!
Little explorers, what letter could it be? It's going to be the letter C. C makes the k sound. Can you say k with me? K. Let's try writing the letter C. You can join in too. Start at the top and work all the way round. Look at all these pictures. Can you tell me which picture begins with the letter C? That's right, caterpillar starts with the letter C. We've been exploring in the garden and look what we found. It's a caterpillar. Did you know that this little caterpillar is actually a baby? Caterpillars are baby butterflies or moths. A caterpillar's journey begins as an egg. And when the egg hatches, out comes a tiny caterpillar, hungry and ready to eat. Caterpillars come in many colours. Some are green, some are stripy, and some even have little spikes. Their colours often help them blend in with the leaves to keep them safe, or sometimes by scaring away hungry birds. Caterpillars are amazing. Did you know that most caterpillars have 12 eyes? 6 on each side of their head. That's a lot of eyes. But even with all those eyes, caterpillars don't see the things the way that we do. Caterpillar eyes help them sense light and movement. And guess what? Caterpillars don't breathe like we do. We breathe through our noses. But caterpillars have tiny holes along their bodies to let air in. It's like having lots of invisible noses. Caterpillars also like to eat a lot. They have strong jaws to help them munch through the leaves, and they will eat leaves all day long to grow bigger and stronger. Let's play a game. Since caterpillars like to eat so much, this little hungry caterpillar wants to munch on lots of leaves. Can you count along with me how many leaves it would like to eat? Are you ready? Let's go! Let's count together.
1, 2, 3, 4, 5.
Good job, little explorers. But the caterpillar's still feeling very hungry. Let's look for more leaves. How many more leaves will this caterpillar want to eat? Are you ready to count?
1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8.
That was excellent counting, but the caterpillar's still feeling very hungry. Let's find some more leaves to count.
1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10.
Great job, little explorers. Our caterpillar is full and is ready for a big change. Did you know that caterpillars don't stay caterpillars forever? This caterpillar will find a safe place and make a chrysalis, also known as a cocoon. Inside the chrysalis, something amazing will happen. The caterpillar transforms. It's what is known as metamorphosis. And when it's ready, the chrysalis will open and out come a beautiful butterfly. The butterfly flaps its wings dry, then flies off to find flowers. Little explorers, our caterpillar friend has just begun a brand new life as a butterfly. I wonder what adventures it will have. Maybe we'll find out one day. One of our favourite stories is The Very Hungry Caterpillar by Eric Carle. We've been inspired to make our own caterpillar craft using materials we found in the garden. Perhaps you'd like to make one too. To make your own hungry caterpillar, you'll need some coloured card, some scissors, some glue, some leaves that we've collected. You'll also need a piece of paper and some crayons. For the hungry caterpillar's face, I've used some coloured card and cut it into circle shapes. I've stuck them together with glue, and then we're going to glue the face onto the paper. Once the hungry caterpillar's face has stuck down to the paper, we're now going to make the body. The body's like a nice curved shape, so we're going to do the same on our piece of paper. We're going to use the glue first and spread it onto the paper. Next, we're going to use the leaves that we've collected earlier to make the body. Each leaf is going to be a segment. Now that we have the hungry caterpillar's body, it's time to draw his feet. Let's count his feet. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. That's 6 little feet we've got to draw for our hungry caterpillar. Now we're going to colour the top of the hungry caterpillar's head. I'm going to be using the blue, red and yellow crayons. And there we have it, our very own hungry caterpillar. Perhaps you'd like to make one too. Today we explored the letter C and discovered all about caterpillars. Can you think of any other things in nature that start with the letter C? Maybe a conker. Or maybe clouds. Keep exploring, keep discovering, and I'll see you next time for another adventure at the Little Nature Club. Bye-bye!